Vivaldi before I go to limitation of the function, I am going through a few rules, and it is very important to know a plus b powered by 2 is a powered by 2 plus double value of the first multiplied by b 2ab plus b powered by 2. The reason of this is a plus b multiplied by a plus b, and it is like a multiplied by a plus b plus b multiplied by a plus b, and when you expand it, it is a powered by 2 plus ab plus ba plus b powered by 2. ba and ab is the same, and it is 2ab. A plus or minus, this is change. Yes, this change. And you are going to have a plus b covered by 3 is a 3 plus three value of the a powered by 2 multiplied by b, or a powered by 2 multiplied by 3 triple b, 3 a 2 b plus triple a multiplied by b powered by 2, 3 a b 2 plus b 3. And when we use minus here is 1b and b is minus, it is so, and here b is powered by 2, then it is positive, but minus b powered by 3 is minus. Another rule you should know about that is a multiplied by 2 minus b multiplied by 2 equals to a minus b multiplied by a plus b, and a multiplied by 3 minus b multiplied by 3 is a minus b multiplied by a 2 plus a b minus a b minus plus a b plus b 2 plus b 2, and a powered by n minus b powered by n is a minus b multiplied by a powered by n minus 1 plus a powered by n minus 2b plus a powered by n minus 3b 2 plus a b powered by n minus 2 plus b powered by n minus 1, and n belongs to natural 6, natural number 6. Value of A plus B is less than or equal to absolute value of A plus absolute value of B. This is a rule. And plus and minus is for both of them. And absolute value of AB, A multiplied by B, is equal to absolute value of A multiplied by absolute value of B. And absolute value of A divided by B is equal to absolute value of A divided by absolute value of B. And what? A power by 2 equals to absolute value of A, and an absolute square of minus 3 power by 2 equals to absolute value of minus 3, which is absolute value of or the value of 3, or simply 3. And when we use arithmetic over absolute values, example, x minus 3 absolute plus absolute x plus 1, equals to x plus 8. And if we solve this problem, x minus 3, we have x, we make it happen, x minus 3, x plus 1, and x plus 8. Because this is absolute, 3 minus 1, 3 minus 8 minus 1, 3. And for this one is 0, and if x is less than 3, it is minus here and plus if x is greater than 3. For this, here, if less than 1 is minus, if greater than 1 is plus. And for x plus 8, it hasn't any absolute, it's plus, it's plus. Then, this part plus this part, both of them are negative. Then, the result is negative. Negative. Yes, please. And it's gone. And this one, x minus 3 is negative and x plus 1 is positive. But between those two, x maximum is 3, it is 4 here, and 3 is 0, then it is positive. And here, x minus 1 is 0 and minus 1 is minus 4, absolute is positive. Then this one is positive here. And here both of them are positive and it is positive. Then it is. For x belongs to minus infinite until minus 1. We have this one negative, then we have negative, then the 3 minus x, and this is negative 2, minus x minus 1, equals to x plus 8. It becomes 2 minus 2x equals to x plus 8. Means that 3x equals to minus 6. We move minus 2x on the right and move 8 to the left. Then x is minus 2. For this part, x belongs to minus 1 and 3. Then x minus 3 is negative, then this is 3 minus x, and x plus 1 is positive, plus x plus 1 equals to x plus 8. Those two take each other, and this is 4 equals to x, then x equals to 4 minus 8. Equals to minus 4. And for x belongs to 3 and infinite, all of them are positive. Then x minus 3 plus x plus 1 equals to x plus 8. Then those two, 2x minus 2. 2x minus 2 equals to x plus 8. Move this x to the left, it becomes x less, 2x minus 8. And 2 minus 2 to the right is 2 plus 8 is 10. Then each time you see a vast absolute value of something, very quick, make a tablet to find about their sign. And another example for this. contest D. After the value of 2x plus 1 divided by 1 min minus x less than or equal to 1. Again, we are building a habit x minus 1/2 and 1. And it is 2x plus 1 and 1 minus x. This one for this value is 0 and this one for this value is 0. So for x less than minus 1/2, then it is negative. And for greater than is positive. For x less than 1, it is positive, and greater than 1 is negative, because x 2, 1 minus 2 is negative, and 1 minus 0 is positive. So now we can write, this belongs to minus infinite minus 1/2. Is negative minus 2x minus 1 divided by 1 minus x, which is positive here. Then it should be less than 1. Then 2x minus 1 plus 1, we multiply with minus 1 in the numerator and denominator. x minus 1 is less than or equal 1, then we multiply 2x plus 1 less than or equal to x minus 1. We move x to the left. 2x minus x is x, and 1 moves to the right, is less than or equal minus 1 minus 1 minus 2. This is the one answer. For x belongs to minus 1 and 1, then this one is positive, 2x plus 1. And this one is positive to 1 minus x less than or equal 1. Now we multiply them there. 2x plus 1 less than or equal to 1 minus x. We move x to the left. 2x plus x is 3x less than or equal 1. This one moves to the right, it's 1 minus 1, is 0, then x less than or equal 0. For x belongs to 1 and infinity, then this one is positive, 2x plus 1, but this one is negative. X minus 1 less than or equal 1. Now we move again or multiply 2x plus 1 less than or equal x minus 1. Move x to the left. 2x minus x is x less than or equal minus 1 plus 1 moves to the right is minus 1 minus 1 is minus 2. okay. Then we have to solve the problem. And we have another definition of summation. Definition of summation, and it is true. Summation k from 1 to n, a index k, is due to definition is a1 plus a2 plus a3 plus an. And for induction tells them 1 show that if we call it P of M, P of M, show that P of 1 is true and 2 is P of N is true, so is P of N plus 1 is true. So I give you an example. P of n equals to sum k from 1 to n k over by 2 is equal to n multiplied by n plus 1 multiplied by 2n plus 1 divided by 6. We want to show that the sum of numbers powered by 2 is this one. Is this expression. So first we show that P of 1 equals to instead of n we put 1 here, 1 multiplied by 1 plus 1 is 2, multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1 is 2 plus 1 is 3, divided by 6. But 1 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 3 is 6, divided by 6 is 1. And here sum which is equal to sum of k from 1 to 1, k followed by 2. Then k starts from 1 and ends from 1. That is one element. It's 1 followed by 2, which is 1. This means that this one are equal. It means that this is true. Now we are going to show. If P1 is true, P of N is true, this is true, then we must show that P of N plus 1 is true too. So, P of N plus 1 equals to sum k from 1 to n plus 1 k followed by 2, which is sum k from 1 to n k followed by 2 plus n plus 1, the last element, n plus 1 followed by 2. But this one is this, is equal to n multiplied by n plus 1 multiplied by 2n plus 1 divided by 6 plus n plus 1 multiplied by 2. Then n multiplied by n plus 1, 2n plus 1 plus 6n plus 1 followed by 2. So we take this one, factor is 0, n plus 1, then it's less n, multiplied by 2n plus 1 plus 6n plus 1 divided by 6. Is it 2n2 equals to n plus 1? Multiplied by 2n2 plus n plus 6n plus 6 divided by 6. And this one, it is n plus 1 multiplied by 2n is less n plus 3 and n plus 6 plus n plus 6 divided by 6. Thank you. multiplied by n plus b multiplied by 2n plus 3 divided by 6. But this means it is the same as n plus 1 multiplied by n plus 1 plus 2 multiplied by 2 n plus 1 plus 1 divided by 6. It means that instead of n here, we have replaced n plus 1. N plus 1, n plus 1 plus 1, n plus 1 plus 1, and n plus 1, 2 n plus 2 plus 1, 2 n plus 1 plus 1. Means that it is true. Means that Pn of 1 is true, and we have come to that expression. Instead of n, we have n plus 1. Okay? Okay. And okay, it was all. And next video is a limitation. Thank you for watching.